Listen to your previous satsangs about Guru Dakshinamurti Stotram. I was going through the third verse. I will just read it out for you. It would be great if you can explain the meaning of the third verse.
Yes.
The verse is Yastheiva Spuranam Sadatmakam Asatkalpartakam Pasake Sakshat Tattva Masiti वेद वचसा यो बोधयत् आश्रितान् यत् साक्षात् करणात् भवेन पुनरावृत्तिर् अवाम्भूनितौ तस्मै श्री गुरुमूर्तये नमयितं श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये.
दिस् इस् द थर्ड वर्स् नो. वी वेर् आलरेडी इन् टु द फस्ट् वन् विश्वं दर्पण दृश्यमान नगरी तुल्यं निजान्तर्कतम्. And then the next, the second verse was Bejas Yantari Vankuro Jagadidam Prang Nirvikalpam Punah. And this is the third verse. See, this is an excellent verse. The way in which this explanation given about the truth by Adi Shankaracharya through this verse, Sadatmakam Asatkalpartakam Bhasate. Let me also read out the verse and we will take out the potent words actually that carries the whole verse in it. Here, Yasya eva spuranam sadatmakam asatkalpartakam basate sakshat tattva masiti veda vachasa yobodayat ashrutan. यत् साक्षात् करणात् भवेन पुनरावृत्तिर् भवाम् बोनिदौ तस्मै श्री गुरुमूर्तये नम इदं श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये. Isn't it? This is the verse. Here we have that Veda Vakya is also brought to light here. साक्षात् तत्त्वमसि इति. Directly Adishankaracharya says this Veda Vakya, the sentence of the Veda, Tattva Masi, you are that. If one says this sentence, utters this sentence as you are that means he pinpointedly denies or removes that we are all not these. It is referred as that. And that is the opposite of this. And what is this? This is nothing but the complete manifestation, including the so-called individual physical body, senses, mind. The moment when we say mind, that is both when it associates itself with the self-luminous true self that is there always like a witness, it acts like as though intelligent. Mind is both intelligent when it reflects the true self, because while investigating the reality or the truth about everything here, the seeker reaches a stage where his mind becomes a sattvic mind. All the blemishes, all the vasanas are completely removed. The sattvic. A sattvic mind can be compared to that of a a luminous light. The sattvic mind itself is Atman. That is how the Vedas and the scriptures say. The very sattvic mind is the pure mind. A mind without any motive, any self-centered activity. A mind without a center. What kind of a mind that be? We can see it in a child. Child of 6 months or 1 year or even 1.5 years. A centerless aliveness alone throbs. You would have seen a depiction of Lord Shiva as a small child lying down and sleeping. It will be, the photo will be very attractive and charming. The Lord Shiva himself is depicted as a child of 1 year and sleeps lying down as it is, as by enjoying a superb bliss. Why the people are, the children are compared to child, especially below the age of 2.5 or 3, where the separate self has not yet gotten into. The child has not started learning the ways of the world, becoming adamant and all this kind of mischievous and all these things with a separate center. Even before that. So it is that the mind, the sattvic mind, can be compared to that state. Here, that is what this Veda Vakyam says. Tattvamasi, you are that. Sakshat Tattvamasi iti Vedavachasa Yaha Bodhayat Ashrutan. One who realizes the meaning, dwells in the meaning of this. See, actually, when these explanations are all given, one should immediately reflect within one's own self. Look at his own body also and senses also. How can I be this flesh and bones alone? Of course, everything is its amsam, that is its part, its play. Everything comes out of it. But I am not this alone. I am not this body alone. I am not these senses alone. I am not this mind alone. I am not this world alone. World of relationships, world of names and forms alone. This is the comprehension or the reflection. Immediately, it cannot be seen elsewhere outside of oneself. It has to be seen immediately, falling back within one's own source only. See, upon coming back only, upon returning only, the mind is quenched. All the hridaya granthis, that is what they say, the doubts that have been existing since millennia in one's heart, that are all satiated, quenched. One undoubtedly takes refuge in that one supreme intelligence, that is not elsewhere outside, that is his very source. That is what, in the first sentence of the verse, Spuranam Sadatmakam. Sadatmakam. Sadatmakam is the word, that is the real, one's own true nature is what appears as the world also. The moment one says world, the individual is very much included. The whole humanity is included. The humanity which was and which is going to be. Everything is included. All kinds of names and forms, the manifestations, right from subatomic forces, the powers of Maya, to the grandest appearance, wonders of the universe, the multitude of stars, the alive stars, everything is included in this. This is what is this Asat Kalpartakam Basate. They are innately unintelligent, right from a thought that is the subtlest thing in this cosmos, and that is the fastest thing also. Because do we not experience this sitting here looking at the sky? Our mind travels faster than our eyes' vision travel, isn't it? Our mind is the fastest thing that travels and looks at the sky and the star, the interstellar system, looking through the telescope or with bare eyes, the thoughts emerge and they go on thinking about how they come to be, how these stars have come to be, how this grand spectra of wonders, that is what the world or the universe be, that has come to be, how one instantaneously, it doesn't actually involves time. Let me ask you one question. As you wake up, as you see the daylight during daytime, does it involve time to perceive that daylight?
No.
It is instantaneous, no? It is spontaneous. At one moment, we can use that word. There is a word, at one moment. In at one moment, in one moment, everything merges. Everything comes to merges in that. That is how this principle, this is not a principle which is an abstract thing, which is the reality. Our minds are so deluded, so clouded, so blemished, one is not able to grasp it immediately. What is this illusion? It is full of traffic. It is full of lot of conceptual video, audio clusters that go on in every one of us. That deludes. And that is supported by the wonders of the external world. The whole of the external world is a wonder of amazement, absolute amazement, stunning amazement. How can such a concrete existence called the waking state universe or the world, how come that be unreal? Because it originates from the true self, the one intelligence. We are forced to use it, pervades in and through and all these words. But it alone is, that is the actual truth. From the point of view of the intelligence or the chitta, there exists no separate reality at all. There is no other reality. There can never be another reality from the angle of the realized souls also. They only see Atman everywhere. The moment the word Atman is brought in here, what actually it means? It says only pure intelligence, omniscience, omnipresence, omnipotence. At every speck of speech, speck of space, that only fills. Space as such also is an inert thing. It's an inert thing. In Sanskrit, they use for a personal consciousness as chittam. It's a combination of chit plus tamas. Tamas is the inert thing, the jada, the unintelligent. The unintelligent. This is what is tamas. And chit is, as we know, it is the pure intelligence. Stainless, blemishless, pure. One thing alone. That is what he here, Yasyaiva Spuranam Sadatmakam, by its omniscience, by its omnipresence alone, by its very nature, the appearance of the world or this universe that one perceives through his senses or mind with the as a world of names and forms, it appears to be real, as though real. See, in this part of the world, we know about duplicate items. Things are as if we can buy a duplicate item from the original brand, original product. Do you know this? We can buy an electronic item also, equally resembling the original, but it is not original. The vendor himself will say, sir, it is duplicate. You will get it at one third of the cost. Instead of 10,000, you give me 3,000 and take this product. It will also work very nicely, but it will almost resemble like the original. But it is not original. In the world of things, when these things can happen, what to say about the original intelligence itself? That is why sage Vasishtha, while imparting the knowledge about the truth, the reality, the chit to Lord Rama, he says it is worth giving life to attain this knowledge. Even one can give up his life. Giving up one's emperorship, ascending to the throne, are all nothing in front of gaining this this knowledge. One's whole life can be given to this. Even if one does not get it in one's lifetime, it is worth giving, attempting to get this knowledge one's life. This is how sage Vasishtha has given to Lord Rama at the age of 9 or 10. So that was the kind of a seeker who was there in the boy Rama. Here the same thing Adi Shankaracharya conveys. Yasyaiva Spuranam, by his luminosity, self-luminosity, self-effulgence, the true chits, the true intelligence, original luminosity, out of that luminosity only, the world, it stuns everyone. One got mixed up in the world, one never even doubts about one's own self as well as the world. That is what is actually Maya. Taking the unreal as real. Taking the duplicate as something original. What is missing in this? The investigation part is missing. One is not investigating it. One does not see through it. So that is the thing. That is how the everyday waking state engulfs, takes one by surprise through his body and senses and authentic psychological movements in oneself as thoughts, feelings and everything about the world. What else our thoughts are made up of? Our thoughts are made up of only names and forms of the world as well as about our own self, with a fake center consistently working to its advancement. That is what is a self-centered activity. Because of that only the thoughts are getting produced. Thoughts are nothing but produced, manifested things. They in no way reveal the reality. That is why through thoughts, through thinking, however cleverly one thinks, however one's analysis be, analysis will not lead one. Here, ఆదిశంకరాచార్య వాట్ ఈ సేస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ హిస్ ఓన్ గ్రేస్ అలోన్ యత్ సాక్షాత్కరణాత్ హీ హెస్ బ్రాట్ దిస్ ట్రూత్ బై హిస్ గ్రేస్ టు యూ. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ వన్స్ ఇంటెలెక్ట్ అటైన్స్ దిస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ త్రూ ద ఎఫర్ట్ ఆఫ్ వన్స్ ఇంటెలెక్చువల్ ప్రాసెస్ వన్స్ గెట్స్ దిస్ విజ్డమ్. హీ గ్రేసెస్ యూ. దట్ ఈస్ వై ద ఫోర్మోస్ట్ థింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ నీడెడ్ ఈస్ కంటైన్ యువర్ ఇంటెలెక్చువల్ జిమ్నాస్టిక్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ డూ నాట్ కంటైన్ ఇట్, ద వర్ల్డ్ విల్ బార్జ్ ఇన్ టు యూ అండ్ ఇట్ విల్ కంటైన్ ఇట్, ఇట్ విల్ సప్రెస్ ఇట్, ఇట్ విల్ బ్రింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ ఇన్ టు యూ. ద ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ దట్ ఆర్ గివెన్ టు యూ ఆర్ ఆల్ రియలీ లెసన్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ విచ్ వన్ షుడ్ యాక్చువల్లీ టేక్ అప్ ద ఎసెన్స్ అండ్ టర్న్ విత్ ఇన్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్. దట్ ఈస్ ద పర్పస్ ద హోల్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్. యాజ్ లైక్ ఫర్ ఎ మూవీ హౌ ద సెట్స్ ఆర్ బీయింగ్ సెట్ ఫర్ ఎ పర్టిక్యులర్ సిచ్యువేషన్ టు బి షాట్, ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే దిస్ అన్రియాలిటీ హౌఎవర్ మైటీ హౌఎవర్ పవర్ఫుల్ ఇట్ అపియర్స్ టు బి, వి ఆర్ సీయింగ్ కాంప్లిమెంటరీ థింగ్స్ దట్ ఈస్ వెల్కనోస్ అండర్ ఓషన్స్. ఇన్ ద డీప్ ఆఫ్ ద సీ బెడ్ దేర్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ వెల్కనోస్. They are complementary. In the pole regions, the North Pole and South Pole, water springs, hot water springs are coming out. One will find hot water springs. They are all complementary things. Nothing is actually only in a man's mind. The pairs of opposites exist. There is nothing called as good as well as evil or bad from the angle of the purity or the one intelligence. That is why here one's ascension towards that reality also includes crossing all the gunas, the qualities. There is a stage, in Sanskrit they ascribe this stage as Gunatitan. One who has transcended all the gunas, the three gunas. Even Sattvika guna should be transcended. Tamas, Rajas, Sat. Even that Sat guna or Sattvika guna, the quality of purity, an unblemished nature, an uncorrupted nature, the pure nature, that is how the true self always is. It never undergoes arisal or disappearance, whereas this duplicate arises with the waking state of a separate psychological center and disappears with the disappearance of the psychological center. That is what, however mighty the world or the powers of the world be, however any number of stars, the innumerable stars that are scattered all around the cosmos, the innumerable, uncountable numbers of, they all depict actually how the truth will be, the substratum, what is the power of that substratum, what is that mightiness, the omniscience of it, the omnipresence of it, the omnipotence of the substratum. This is what actually by turning within, one comes to understand by and by, it reveals. We cannot even say that an individual out of his own efforts understand this. It is dawning to one. It is happening to one. It is revealed to one. This is what he says in the second sentence. Sakshat tattvamasi iti veda vachasa yo bodhayat ashritan. By that sentence, the seeker is attracted or drawn within and he is immersed in that bodha. That bodha means that higher conscious state of living. He is always abides in that, beyond this body mind separation. Yo bodhayat, yaha bodhayat ashridan. Bodhayat means, bodha means a state of higher consciousness. That consciousness is what is here told. In the first sentence he has given asat kalpartakam basati, the so called appearance like a mirage like, but upon inquiry there exists no water at all in the mirage. In the same way, upon inquiry about the world, the existence of the world, immediately when one is taken by the stunning appearance of the world, one should immediately ask this question: to whom this stunning appearance has arisen? Who sees this? Who is taken by the wonders of this appearance? Who in me perceives this? Not even the perception. What is that capacity that makes me, that makes this center within a body through its senses and the mind is undergoing this experiencing, seeing the wonders of the creation as if real? What is that faculty? How has it come to be? From where does it come? The capacities that are being displayed by the senses or the mind. Just think of the mind. Does it ever rest? Throughout our waking state, when one travels to the corners of the world, to the deepest jungles of Amazon also, what is it that one is with? He is with his mind. The mind only has taken the body to the deepest dark jungles there and probing something, losing oneself as the body and mind. The mind makes him to get lost in that sights. Isn't it? So which is actually all along in one's pursuits, right from the moment the body has taken a form, a birth, for the mind. It is mind's body, not the other way around. It is not the body's mind. It is the mind's body. Body and the world and every name and form is working like slave. They all work like slaves under one fake controller called mind. Here, these people have the seers, Adi Shankara, Bhagavat Pada, Ramana Maharshi, and all these great rishis. They have arrived at the terminus. What is the terminus? That bodha. Yo bodhayat ashritan. The higher conscious destination, the only conscious, the only intelligent, the only omniscient, the only omnipresent, omnipotent destination, that is what the reality is. There is nothing else at all. To these destinations, they had arrived. Does not this verse convey a permanent settled state that they undergo? Upon that conviction, the verses come out through Adi Shankara Bhagavat Padal. Has not the highest has descended through these words? That is what these words reveal. Now we will get to that. What is the effect that happens to one who has arrived at the destination in the Bodha of the one Chit, the one intelligence. Only one intelligence is there, that is not even for communication purpose, I am using the word one. That is why they always these three words, they go together, Satchitananda. The first word is Sat. The part of Satness or easeness. What is the vouching proof for this Sat, the presence of Sat? That is omnipresence. For omnipresence, what is the vouching proof? You see the world. In our waking state, everything is the expression of the Sat part, the omnipresent part of its proved, of the truth is proved by the presence of the world at large, the magnificent universe with innumerable countless stars, countless wonders, unbelievable. Even to moon or some other planet, if man happens to go there, does not the humanity's mind go there? Is it not the fact? Wherever the human body, wherever an expression of a form, does it not prove the existence of the subtle body, mind there? And who is the controller of the mind? How mind, as though real, bring one's form also as some separate reality, and the world in which he lives also a separate true reality. How this illusion happens? Because of the presence of that, the substratum is originally intelligent, whereas these are not intelligent at all. They are not intelligent at all. Nowhere in the universe or cosmos there exists a separate intelligent center. There is no separate self-existing truth or reality or some occupying an atomic space or a power also. That is why wherever to any corner of this universe the man may be able to go in future, what actually goes is already the Atman is already there through his mind. That only driven him to go there. That only urged him to seek out for discovery or truth. So the basal science, that is why Atmajnana is a science of its own without a second. And the kind of settled feeling as if, yes, I have arrived home after a long, vicious circle of torture and tribulations. This entity which was engrossed in ignorance, in millions of births and deaths, taking different forms and undergoing different experiences from the atomic level, from the microcosmic level to the very grand experiences, as if the appearance of the world and stars and all these things. One finally returns back home, realizing everything whatever I have perceived so far does not have intelligence at all of its own. I was simply examining a seashell, taken it to be the real silver because of the lighting condition that prevailed at the time of seeing it. I mistook it as silver, whereas it is not silver at all. It is an empty shell, even a human skull that was lit because of the full moon in a desert. as if like a silver. But whereas when the sun has dawned, he comes to realize, oh, what is this? It was a skull, a dead man's skull. It appeared as though like a silver. It is like that we are mistaking right from our, even our, the sensory perceptions onwards, feeling level onwards, from the thought movement onwards, we have mistaken ourselves as something intelligent, originally intelligent, whereas we, this everything that has come to be is not intelligent at all. That's why that settled feeling or settled convinced arrival, an arrival of conviction that has happened to these great souls, Adi Shankara, Bhagavad Pada and all the great souls, how has it happened? They are in that bodha, they are in that state, they have transcended the gunas, they have transcended this world of appearance, names and forms, and the whole cosmos, including their own ego, they have annihilated. It is not a tortuous path. Actually, the truth is real. But getting rid of the false is the actual challenge to every one of us. And it cannot be given by anyone at all in this world. One has to seriously take this on oneself. Live through it. Seriously. Whatever I am talking, they have all lived like this. Every moment was worth millions of realization process to go through. It's not a thing which can be wasted just like that. This is what Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya, he says, Sakshat Tattvamasi. Tattvamasi, the word communicates this, and in that bodha, that which was communicated in that state, the state of omnipotency, omniscience and omnipresence, Satchidananda state, in that he dwells. Yat Sakshat Karanat, by having arrived, what happens? Punaravruti na bhavet. Punaravruti means, avruti means circle. Punaravruti means the circle of samsara. See, everything here is happening mechanically. Man may be able to reach another earth also, some other earth-like place, but what will he find there? What will he find there? It is the urges of him that drives in one, that only makes one to probe into the external world, probe into the interstellar system and the planetary systems of the other galaxy and all these new inhabitations. What else will he be finding? Will that be intelligent in any way? Because the very intellect which is involved in all these things is not intelligent on its own. It is an arisal. It comes and goes. It comes in the waking state, it disappears in the deep sleep. And one fine day, without a body, it hangs in the middle, without any support. What are all this empty space? Yet to be manifested. It is filled with the unmanifest things. This is a mechanical cycle. Why does the earth rotate on its axis, thereby creating days and nights? ceaselessly. With this, the poets write beautiful poetic versions of the nature and things, and the every new dawn and every beautiful nights. What are all these things? What is this platform which is mechanically happening? Anything that goes and comes, what is the nature of it? Are they not mechanically appearing and disappearing? Every waking state, every new day that dawns, is it not a mechanical happening? Is there in the sky anything called as this is another day in the calendar of 2012 or 2013? Like that? Outwardly, there is no trace of any mark there. With the return, with the arrival, with the destination being reached, having arrived at the destination, what happens to one is, it puts an end to this nonsense. What is that nonsense? The mechanical way of arisal and disappearance. As one's waking state, as in the cosmos, as a new day and another night. A new season and another season. Like this, the millennia of years are passing by, and the human beings go on changing. New beings come into existence. They go away in time. Everything becomes the food for time, the concept of time. And one lives in time. One takes himself, this body, as something real. These are all coming to an end. This whole mad game, play, magical play. And this whole set is only for this purpose, nothing else. That is what he says. Yat is Sakshat Karanat. This awakening has been made by Lord Dakshinamurti, by his benign presence. He reveals this. Sakshat Karanat means he has made this to be realized. Yat is Sakshat Karanat, he has made this to be realized. For what to happen? No more samsara, no more appearing and disappearing. Punaravritti na bhavet bhavam bonitau tasmai Sri Guru Murti namaidam Sri Dakshina Murtaye. Which realization alone puts an end to the cycle of samsara, the cycle of births and deaths. And that is being revealed by the only Lord through silence, through his very appearance as Sat Chit Ananda, omnipresence, omniscience, omnipotence. Because the potency itself is blissfully playing it out on its own. This is what he says. To that Lord Dakshinamurti, the supreme being, embodied in the auspicious and benign Guru, I offer my profound salutations. This is what the verse is, Vivek. Shall we go through the verse once again?
Yes.
Yasyaivas puranam sadatmakam asat kalpartakam basati sakshatattvam asiti vedavachasa yo bodayat ashritan. Yat sakshat karanat bhavena punaravruttir bhavam bonidau tasmai Sri Guru Murtaye namaidam Sri Dakshina Murtaye. By and by, the gaze, the inner gaze, the turning within See, none of the physical things will lead us to salvation or self-realization. Mistakenly, people are made to think through physical acquisitions, through physical siddhis also, through attainment of various powers, subtle mental powers, those are all psychological powers. See, for all the psychological powers or physical powers that are manifested, that are already in display, the earth is hanging out in space. Is it not a fact? What siddhi, what kind of a miracle will be higher than this? All the planets are hanging out in empty space. A rock-like moon, satellite is revolving around this mother earth. Isn't it? Nothing out there in the moon. Conquering the moon or going to different planets, in what way the ego only brings in all the differences to other beings also throughout this world, isn't it? They have achieved, we should also achieve that. But what is the purpose? Which is intelligent? Which is real intelligence? That settlement, they have got it. The seers have got it. Who is a real Siddha? Who is the real attainer here? One has really become the omniscience itself, the chit itself. The chit itself. Will anyone desire to be a part of it and show equivalently produce magic in this world equivalent to chit? It is childish to the display of magical powers. Is there any human being can create the chits, the miracles that are already happening day in and day out throughout the cosmos? Can anyone mimic that? Is it not the real attainment? From where do all these wonders, all these miracles happen? Who is the source of all the miracles? Who is the real Siddha? The Shiva, the Linga, a symbol, the state, is the real Siddha. That is the state one should aspire for. So that is the truth. Self-realization is also a process that doesn't give out guarantees of physical things at all. Physical accomplishments nor psychological powers. It's pure jnana. In jnana alone, everything exists. Have you understood? So here, sadatmakam asatkalpartakam basate was the one important word. Sakshat tattvam asi iti vedavachasa. Yaha bodhaya tashritan. In which kind of that bodha or the consciousness one lives. Yati sakshat karanat. What happens to one who has arrived home, is not caught anymore in this mechanical repeatedness. He has become that Sachidananda itself. What people are made to think after death or during existence or during one's life itself, what happens? Something as subtly one happens to one, some illuminating light dawns, engulfs one's body or something. Somewhere in a location he disappears like a miracle. These are all very silly aspects of understanding the self-realization. Powers, the power of self-realization or understanding of jnana. This does not take place like that at all. This is not bodily oriented at all. When a thought itself is a physical thing, then thought itself is a physical thing, any attainment, self, meaning the self-realization to be something of physical nature with the mental powers and other things, is a childish way of looking at it. This is total dissolution of the nonsense that is happening as a material movement, which never actually in the first place exists from the angle of jnana or self-realized process. It is a perfected state. That is why the Shanti Mantra also says, Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate. They mean it as Puranam. Puranam means perfect. Purnamadah. There also, that also is Purana. Purnamidam. Whatever that has come into manifestation is also Purana. Purnat Purnamudachyate. From out of the totality, oneness, even whether it is an atom or a new universe that is born, both are insignificant. They don't stand separately at all, apart from it. So out of that Purana only, manifestation also comes into existence. Purna Purna Mudachyate. Purnasya Purna Madaya. Adaya means after taking it out, out of that perfection, that which is born, also Purana, that also expresses itself as Purana only, because every atom is perfect here. They say the standard particle, no? The standard particle consists of so many things, subatomic particles. That is what that group that contains that standard particle. The same way, everything is perfect here. They behave in the same way, be it the universe or the subatomic particle. So after the Purana, the perfect is, perfect as manifested as this, after that has taken as manifestation, still what is left over is also Purana. It doesn't fall short of, after its removal, a part being removed from it, there is no part at all. Everything is Purana here. Everything is Purana. There is no imperfection at all. There is no lackness at all. So everything is Purana, at all times Purana, at all places Purana, and it is omniscience. That is what is the state of jnana. It can never be compared to that of a physical happening. That too, the psychological, mental happening also, be it the miracles or the powers of thought. Powers of thought are sheer childish display. They are not real at all. Any amount of achievement, even through mind, that will come and go with one's waking state only, because mind itself comes only in the waking state. Then where is the question of its presence in the deep sleep? So it is an arisal and disappearance. This is what is samsara. Beyond this is jnana, and that is being given in this verse. Shall we stop at this and pursue the next verse after some time? Are you clear?
Yes.
Have you understood?
Yes, I want to shoot the meaning of the sloka.
Okay, you want to read out the sloka once?
Yes.
Please go ahead.
Shall I read it?
Please go ahead.
Yasya eva spuranam adatmakam asat kalpartakam pasate sakshatatva masiti veta vachasa yobodayat ashrutan.
Yes, It's fine. We will stop at this. We will meet in the next Satsanga.